Hi everyone, welcome to Java Wave, where we will discuss about Java interview questions and their answers. I am Gayatri and today we are going to discuss how to create user-defined or custom immutable class in Java. So let's start creating custom immutable class or user-defined immutable class. Immutable class should be whose value once created it cannot be changed. So first condition to create a class as immutable class is it should be final so that it cannot be extended. So first rule to create a class immutable class, we should declare that class as final. Second rule, declare all the instance variable as private and final. So that their value cannot change inside class also once it is initialized. Third rule is initialize instance variable via constructor. So I'll create one constructor here. And I'll initialize this string value via constructor. Fourth rule is don't provide setter method to this instance variable so that once it is initialized, it cannot be set again. I have only getter method here. So now my immutable class got created. Class is final so that it cannot be extended and modified. Instance variable is private and final so that it cannot be changed once it is initialized inside the class also. I am initializing this instance variable via constructor and there is no setter method for this instance variable. So its value cannot be set again once it is initialized. As we all know, string is already a immutable class. So this code is valid for string or any other immutable class like all the wrapper classes. But if I am using object of any other mutable class as instance variable, we should take extra care. Like if I am using object of string buffer, which is a mutable class, we should not directly copy the value of string buffer while initializing. So what I will do, while initializing, I'll create one new object of string buffer and I'll pass this original object as input argument. I could have done it in this way also. Like I did for this string variable. But whenever I am doing in this way, I have not given any setter method for my class, but since string buffer is already a mutable class, there are many other setter methods available in string buffer that can be used to change this value. So if I am assigning value in this way, setter method of string buffer class cannot change value of string buffer object of this class. And in getter method also, we should not directly return original object, rather than we should return copy of that object. So I will write that code also. So I'll create getter method and I need only getter. So rather than returning directly original object. I'll create in this way. So now in this class we are using object of one immutable class and another one is mutable class. In this way we can create our custom immutable class or user defined immutable class. As we discussed, there are 5 rules to create any class as immutable class. Declare class as final class so that no other class can extend it and override its method. All the instance variables should be private and final so that once it is initialized, its value cannot be modified within class also. Initialize all the instance variable via public constructor. Don't provide setter method to instance variable so that once it is initialized, its value cannot be set again. And if we are using any mutable object as instance variable, return copy of mutable instance variable rather than returning original object. So these are 5 rules to create any class as immutable class. With this, we covered all the point of this topic. To know about more Java interview question every week, please subscribe my channel Java Wave and write in comment box if you have any suggestion or question for me. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.